January 11th, 2003. I was born in San Jose, California. I've lived here in San Lorenzo for pretty much my entire life. When I was only 10 months old, my parents decided to leave the US for a little and go to Mexico to see your family there. There I had my first birthday, and while of course I don't remember much, I do sometimes get memories of small things like the blue chair that I love for some reason or how close I was to my grandma. But sadly, that was going to be the last time in 10 years before I'd get to see most of my family in Mexico again, because sure enough, a few months later, we came back to the US. I've moved a couple of times, but the farthest I've ever moved was across the street. But on December 4th, 2005, something very unfortunate happened. My sister was born premature. She was born 6 months into the pregnancy and spent the first 3 months of her life in the hospital. I was only around 2 or 3 at the time, and I had no idea how serious it was. All I remember was staying at my aunt's house in the day and in the afternoon going to see my mom in the hospital. At the time, things seemed hopeless, and the doctor said my sister was never going to be able to walk. However, 3 years later, she started walking and she can now even talk. Well, sorta.
Thank you!
And now on to two people who know me the best.
When I first saw Francisco, I thought, wow, this kid is annoying yet smart. I'm gonna have a great year. Just as soon as I seen him, like, I knew he was gonna like chill and cool. And I learned many new things because of him. I think he doesn't hang out with me much now since he got a girlfriend, but he's still really cool with me, so I'm glad that he's still true. I see him making a lot of money with his wife, probably. I see him being a successful kid. I really do.
Let's see, I met Francisco somewhere early this year. We both have zero period together, so he was a bit noticeable to me since I was one of the first few people to actually be there early. Then turns out later on those few weeks, I would actually find out that he has more classes with me than I expected. It gave me a chance to chat with him. What I first thought of Francisco was that he was a very friendly and approaching person, which was one of the few reasons why I decided to talk to him in the first place. He was the only one who seemed to have stood out to me the most. So I decided, why not make a new friend this year? At first, I thought that he was still gonna be remaining a bit of a shy person since when approaching to him, he didn't seem to talk that much. But as soon as time went on, he actually became a very lovable, kind, helpful, and intelligent person.
And that's it. I'm really grateful for the people that I have in my life and what I've been able to do, and I can't wait to see what the future brings.
Wait, what? Why is everybody still surrounding you in the background?
I love you, Francisco.